For this exercise, we have given three different statements. A is a subset of B, the intersection of A and B is A, and the union of A and B is B. Now we need to show that all those three statements are equivalent, which means that we need to show that A is true if and only if B is true, and likewise B is true if and only if C is true. But in this video we are going to use a circular chain of implications to prove the equality of those three statements. So we basically assume that A is true and then show that B is also true. Likewise, we go from B to C and from C again to A. And by that we can go from A to B, back from B to A, and also from B to Z and back. For the first subproof, we will show that A implies B. Therefore, we will assume that A is a subset of B, and under this assumption, we need to show that the intersection of A and B is equal to A. You should know that whenever we have to prove an equality of sets, we have to show that the left side of the equation is a subset of the right side of the equation, and we also have to show that the right side of the equation is a subset of the left side of the equation. So this is exactly what we are going to do. Usually we wouldn't have to show this statement because it is obvious that the intersection of A and B is a subset of A. But we will show it anyways. So whenever we have to prove that one set is a subset of another set, we can take a random element from the subset. So let's say X is an element of the intersection of A and B. And now we have to show that X is also an element of A. We can just replace the intersection with a logical AND, and we get that X is an element of A and X is an element of B. So we know that X is an element of A. For the other direction, we have to show that A is a subset of the intersection of A and B. Therefore, again, we will start by taking a random element from A. So we say that X is an element of A. And now we can use the assumption from above. So we know that A is a subset of B. And therefore, if the element X is in A, we definitely know that it is also in B. So we can say that X in A implies that X is in A and X is in B, which is the definition of X being in the intersection of A and B. For the subproof from B to C, we can assume that B is true. So we assume that the intersection of A and B is equal to A. And we need to show that under this assumption, C is true. Hence, we need to show that the union of A and B equals B. And because we need to show that two sets are equal, we will again show that the left side is a subset of the right side, and we will also show that the left side is a superset of the right side. To show that the union of A and B is a subset of B, we will again take a random element of the left side. So we say let X be in the union of A and B, which is by definition nothing else than X is in A or X is in B. For the next step, we will need to translate our assumption, which states by definition that X is in A and X is in B if and only if X is in A. So we can go from the left side of the equation to the right and also in the other direction. And because X is in A is equivalent to the left statement, we can replace it here. So again, we used our assumption to replace X is in A with X is in A and X is in B, because from the assumption we know that those two statements are equivalent. As a next step, we can expand our statement. Hence, we get in parentheses X is in A or X is in B, and in parentheses X is in B or X is in B. Because the statement is joined with a logical AND, we are allowed to imply one of those two statements, and we will imply the right side, which is X is in B or X is in B, which is of course the same as saying X is just in B. And remember, this is exactly what we wanted to show. For the next step, we need to show that B is a subset of the union of A and B. And we don't really have to prove it because this statement is always true. Lastly, we also need to show that Z implies A, which means that we have to show that if the union of A and B equals B, A is also a subset of B. So we will take a random element from A and show that it is also in B. And well, if we know that X is in A, we can of course just imply that X is in A or X is in B, because we know that X is in A is a true statement, and therefore the statement as a whole is also true, because it is joined with a logical OR. And by definition, this is nothing else than X being in the union of A and B. Because the assumption states that the union of A and B is the same as B, we know that if X is in the union of A and B, it also has to be in B. With that, we have shown that A implies B, B implies C, and C implies A. And that is why we know that all those three statements are equivalent.